Olá, sejam bem-vindos ao programa Saúde e Bem-Estar. No programa de hoje temos a convidada Katie Herrera, Territory Manager do Starkey Canada. Olá.
Olá, Carlos.
Tudo bem?
Tudo bem, gracias.
Tudo bem. So today we're going to speak a little bit of English, Portuguese, and a little bit of Spanish for you people that understand Spanish and Portuguese or English. Anyhow, Katie, can you tell us a little bit about Starkey and the role that they play in the world of hearing?
Certainly. Starkey has been around since 1957, and it's a global company that really puts its focus on innovation, but most importantly, helping people and helping patients hear the very best they can.
Mm-hmm. I can attest to that. That is definitely my experience with Starkey from the beginning, that their heart is in every single fitting, right from the top, from Mr. Austin and Miss Austin. They are truly involved in the hearing world, and they truly want the best for people that are hard of hearing. With Starkey being one of the leading companies in the world, tell us a little bit about how they go about their research and development, how they develop their products to help people hear.
So we have a team all around the world. Right now we have a new facility based out of Tel Aviv in Israel, where we have all of our smartest brains working together to develop some of these technologies. Mm-hmm. So one of the most exciting ones that we have just released is our artificial intelligence mm-hmm. and sensors built into the hearing aids mm-hmm. that actually try to mimic what the human brain can do. How amazing is that?
Incredible. It's actually incredible. I've been talking about this for a little while, that Starkey's a leader, always in research and development. They were the first ones to come out with the smallest hearing aid that Ronald Reagan wore back in, do you remember the year? Probably in somewhere in the late 70s, I'm going to guess.
I think so.
And then recently, you know, most recently in the last 10 years, I know that we know that Starkey was the first to create and develop and build and implement an invisible hearing aid. So I speak from experience. I know that I've been fitting a lot of people with invisible hearing aids. It's a challenge, but when it works, it's so satisfying. It's so gratifying that people can wear something and not, you can't tell that they're wearing a hearing device. So for sure, I know Starkey is way ahead of the other manufacturers, let's say, when it comes to certain areas of hearing. In terms of Starkey as an organization, as a family, you know, maybe just touch a little bit about on how they live their day-to-day lives in the hearing world.
Certainly. So we take our example from Mr. Bill Austin and his wife, Mrs. Tanny Austin. So they work every single day to provide the very best hearing for every patient all the time. It's such an incredible thing to see them at work. And on a level more locally, we go to work every day with that passion to help people hear the very best they can. So whether that's through offering something as amazing as an invisible hearing aid, or helping a customer in their office with counseling a patient on perhaps some of the neat things that hearing aids can do now. Mm-hmm. There's so much that goes into our people to be able to then serve our customers the very best that we can.
Absolutely. And so you touched on this a second ago, so I want to go back to this about the AI intelligence. So we talk about our artificial intelligence all the time, and the world is changing all the time, and it's really important that you know that in the future, artificial intelligence is going to be part of even more part of our lives. It's a part of our lives now. But hearing devices now become so sophisticated that within the device itself, it can tell if a person's fallen down. It can call somebody, you know, in an emergency situation. It can do language translation. It could do any kind of, you know, I joke about this, but it's true. I believe that in the future, you know, the cell phones that we use today will probably be in our ear, part of it, or a lot of it, because we'll be able to tap on that device
Absolutely.
And ask for directions and so on. But really, you know, the technology and the benefits are what's important for people, but I want to stress that, you know, Starkey's a special company. I'm saying that and I mean that. And I mean that because I know from experience that I've seen, you know, the people that own and run this company do a lot of good work all over the world. And they are really the only company that is privately owned. All the other hearing companies, they're good companies. They produce a lot of nice products, good products. But Starkey is the only company that has a couple that are at the top, that are oversee the work day to day, and actually are still working in the clinic day to day. Sometimes Mr. Austin, I know he's there till 11, 12 o'clock at night, feeding people with hearing aids, but they have a vision. They're really into research and development, but even more importantly, I want to share with you folks, some of you know that I've participated in other events outside of day-to-day activity in Canada. This is a perfect opportunity to present, you know, a person that's been involved both with the company day-to-day business and activities, but also the activity or the efforts that go into a higher level of care of people. And what I'm referring to is our hearing aid missions.
Correct. And these are wonderful, wonderful experiences that not everyone is able to have, but when you do, it really is a blessing. And the wonderful thing is that we're able to travel to some of the poorest countries in the world and give the gift of hearing. Mm-hmm. So there's nothing better than that. Someone who may never have had the opportunity to even go to school because they can't hear, now they're able to participate in class, participate in their community, and most importantly, give back to their communities as well.
Okay, I want to reemphasize this point.
Yes.
So, you know, we hear about charities and people looking after others and caring for others, but I have to tell you firsthand, I've experienced it myself, being able to travel to a few places, like Peru is one, El Salvador with Caddy, we were there on the same mission. I know that, you know, I know what they're doing. They're fitting, you know, 2,000-3,000 people in a short time, sometimes 2-3 days, sometimes 2,000 people a day. It's a cooperative effort. There's a lot of people. There's often the Lions Club involved, where they bring people and they prep for that day because it's organized probably a year or two in advance. And then what Starkey does is provide, you know, the product 100%. And more importantly, which is something that Tanny Austin, you know, suggested or implemented, is the sustainability. And the concern was, and I know from my experience, that people need care. They need to be seen after the fact. It's not a magic pill. Here you go. See you later. And so what they've continued to do is provide the care for the people that get these devices on site by training people on site and providing full care batteries, I think, for life.
Yep.
Is that right?
And interestingly enough, you know, with what is going on around the world right now, to know that there are local ambassadors, local healthcare teams that patients can then go see is such a relief because, again, we don't just go in and provide the devices and say goodbye. We really want to make sure that the patient, from the time they get their first hearing aid to the time they get their very last hearing aid,
absolutely,
that they're being looked after. Yeah. So
that's fantastic. Well, I want to thank you for coming. I'm really
thank
happy
you,
to
Carlos.
Have you here. I hope folks have enjoyed our short time here. I just want to stress that this is a company with heart, and if you're ever thinking of getting hearing help, Starkey is the name of the company. I would seriously consider working with Starkey. They're people that care. Thank you, and we'll see you the next time. Muito obrigada, até a próxima. Muito obrigado.
Muito obrigada.